everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's today's Emcee on Tattletales Emcee Week, star of The Price is Right, Bob Barker.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'll tell you, I've learned one thing. You get a lot more applause when you limp, don't you? Huh?
Oh. How'd you break your toe?
I have a broken toe.
A lot of sympathy,
toe.
Too.
But, I'm brave and I'm going to carry on. I want to welcome you to the Bob Barker Show 76. We have Emcee Week here on Tattletales, and Bert Convy did the show himself on Monday, and Gene Rayburn did a beautiful job yesterday, and I propose to do a better job today. Now, I'd like to have you meet our panel over here. First of all, may I introduce the lovely Elaine Joyce.
I love you, Bob
who
Barker.
Brought with her Bobby Van of Show Off. Here they are.
I love you.
Thank you. Thank you. So nice to be here.
Bob and, Barker, you're terrific.
Bobby, how do you feel today?
I feel great, and Elaine's going to be crazy about you because you gave her first billing.
Well, I promised her that I would. Well, Elaine, you're lovely.
You're a sweetheart.
Yes, I think I'll go back there.
Wait a minute.
Come on.
Now, next to Bobby
Chicken.
Here, we have the fellow that, of course, you recognize if you have been watching Tattletales, as you should, the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy, and his wife, Annie.
Thank you.
Hello.
Bananas. Hey.
What are you doing?
And Bert, what comments do you have on the way the week is going so far?
So far, it's going really good. I there's one thing I do miss, and that is the kiss that you get when you get the microphone from a pretty girl like that. I forgot about that. Oh, you didn't know about that, did you, Ann?
No, what?
Nothing, Ann. Sorry. Everything is fine so far. Somehow you put me in the bananas, and I feel I belong here. It seems only proper.
And Annie, you'll be playing for the banana section
That's
today.
That's right.
And I wish you luck.
Thank you. We're ready.
What did he mean by that?
For her, it's perfect casting.
So. Yes. Now, down on the end, the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn and his wife, Helen. Gene?
Yes.
Hey, you did a beautiful job yesterday, and I can tell you're in a beautiful mood today.
I thank you.
And Helen, we'll be expecting you to match everything Gene says in here.
With last billing, I'll try my best, Bob.
Now, I have a first question here, which we'll ask you girls to answer. And it's not a question, it's a letter, actually. Ladies, you win a showcase. And incidentally, we'll have some questions that tie in with Truth or Consequences or with The Price is Right or beauty pageants or the type of thing that I do. Ladies, you win a showcase on a special edition of The Price is Right. And I offer you the famous Bodinor diamond. It's worth $1 million, but it carries a legendary curse that its owner will die a horrible death within 5 years. A dozen owners have died this way. I stipulate that you must keep the diamond for 10 years before you can sell it. Now, would you accept this prize or turn it down? Now, you think it over for a moment. Goodbye, girls. And while they're thinking, Bobby, I'd like to have you tell us, do you think that Elaine will accept this diamond or will she not?
What I think?
Mm-hmm.
I think she wouldn't touch it with a 10-foot pole.
$1 million diamond.
I don't care what it is. I don't think she... money means nothing if you're going to die. And if there's a chance she might die, she's not going to touch this diamond. You want to throw in a Rolls Royce and a fur coat? No, I don't really think that she'd touch it. I would hope that she wouldn't, because I wouldn't want to even worry about it when it was 4 years and 11 months, and nothing's happened.
All right, let's find out. Now, Bobby says that she will not accept it. Let's have Elaine back here. Elaine, hi. You remember the question? It's
no, I want you to read it again.
It's only a half-hour show.
No, I'm
Elaine,
kidding.
Would you accept the diamond or would you not?
Now, all the people who have owned it have died, huh?
Yes.
Bobby's not going to believe this, Bob, but I wouldn't accept it.
You would not accept it? That makes Bobby very happy.
Oh, you're kidding!
Yeah.
That's what I said, Bobby.
That's right. That's what he predicted you would say.
That's
not
right.
Only is Bobby happy, the blue section
that's
is happy.
That's right.
Are you happy too, Bob?
Of course I am. I don't want
no,
anything to
not
happen to you.
You.
The hell with the diamond. Who cares about a diamond?
Bob, you, Barker. Bob.
Yes, I'm happy for you.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Bob's in the world.
On we go to you, Bert. Bert, what do you predict?
Is this a fact? I mean, this really is a fact? Did this happen?
Well, I don't know. It's your show. Are these always factual?
Well, I always
these
like to know
they put
where
on
you
these,
get this information.
That you read, are they always factual?
Not always, no.
No.
What's the name of the diamond?
The Bodinor diamond.
The Bodinor diamond?
Bodinor diamond.
Yeah. Well, if it was the
it's
Hulk
worth $1 million.
The name is what diamond it is.
But its owners have died horrible deaths
in
10 years. 5 years.
Oh, within 5 years. And I got to
think
keep
how much
10.
Fun you could have with $1 million for 5 years.
Yeah, but not if you've been dead for 5 years.
A dozen owners have died this way.
What?
A dozen owners have died.
A dozen have died.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if I wanted to get rid of her, I could tell her to keep the diamond, couldn't I? But I don't want to. No, I'm crazy about her. I don't think she'll... She won't go for the diamond.
She will not accept the diamond.
She won't take it.
All right, the banana section seems pleased. Let's find out. Annie, let's have her back. Annie, you have heard the question. Tell me, would you accept the Bodinor diamond or not with its curse?
No, I don't. I'm a very cheap date. My idea of fashion is blue jeans and a new pair of mucklucks. I don't want the diamond.
That's you right. Do not. All right. On we go to you, Gene.
Well, now, listen, you said 5 years. They die in 5 years.
They die within 5 years.
Well, you say you got to keep it for 10 years. Well, how the heck can you do that if you're going to be dead in 5 years?
Well...
What kind of dumb question is this?
It's going to... The second 5 years, you won't go out a lot and wear it, apparently. But I guess the hope is that if you accept it, the curse would not have its effect on you, and you would go on... And in any event, you can't get rid of it for 10 years.
Well, you didn't tell me that, or I'd have taken the diamond.
You mean it's not certain that you're going to die?
Oh, just answer the question, Gene.
Well,
you might.
It's just that it does have a curse that its owner will die a horrible death within 5 years. Now, it's not guaranteed that you will die. Perhaps we could add that to the warranty if you wish. But
it's 12 months or whoever dies first.
Yeah. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. Well, I'm... Well, if you're going to die, who wants a diamond? Life is more valuable than a diamond.
Yes. Right. Is that your answer, then, that you will not?
I don't think Helen will go for it.
You do not?
Yeah, if she's going to.
All right. The red section seems to be pleased. Let's have Helen with us, then. Helen, are you going to accept the diamond, or are you not?
Well, if you gave it to me today and I kept it for 10 years, I'd be 102 by the time the curse was over, so I'd keep it.
So you're keeping the diamond? Oh, gee. Gene had predicted that you would not keep the diamond, Helen.
Oh, boo,
gee,
boo, Helen.
Gene. Oh, what a shame. Gene.
It was cheap.
But of course, with Match Game doing so well, Gene will probably buy you one anyway.
That's right.
Now, let's see. We have Elaine and Bobby were correct in their answer. Ann and Bert were correct in their answer. Each of you has won $75 on our first question. And we will be back with our second question, and who knows what, after this.
Run to waterjetoffer.com. Order now.
All right, on we charge here now. We had two correct answers to our first question. Elaine and Bobby have $75. Ann and Bert have $75. Helen and Jean are having a lot of fun on Tattletales. Now, girls, here's the second question for your consideration.
Okay, we're ready.
This spring, I'll be hosting the Miss USA beauty pageant again. Let's say that you and your husband are two of the judges. Do you think you'd cast your votes for the same girl or for different girls? Now, you think that over for a few moments, and we'll have you back with us shortly. Goodbye, girls. And this time, I'm going to start with you, Bert.
Oh, I knew it.
Would you cast your votes for the same girl or for different girls?
Well, depends on... I could get in a lot of trouble with this, you know?
Lied, Bert.
You got a lot of trouble yesterday and the day before
I'll
without
be getting
this.
In trouble right along because, well, obviously I like her type, Anne's type, that is, or I wouldn't have married her. But then again, if you see somebody, you know, who's interesting from another country, you go for other things, too.
Now, this is the Miss USA beauty pageant.
Oh, Miss USA.
Yes,
oh, well,
so
in that case, no problem.
States.
I'd vote for Miss Oklahoma because that's where Annie's from. I think if it's Miss USA, if you make that clear.
Yes.
Different.
There's some great minds in the banana section. One knows there's 50 states, you see.
Are you kidding? I know the bananas. Forget about it. I'm going to say this. Oh, boy.
Well, do you like the same type of girl? Does she? Well, you answer the question. It's your question.
I don't think I like where you were going there, Bob.
Well, no, my idea was that...
I got to answer this thing. I'm going to say that we would like the same kind.
You would like the same girl. All right.
Is that it? The same girl.
Well, now don't bring Anne back for a moment.
Wait.
Would you cast your votes for the same girl or for different girls?
Same girl.
Okay, let's have Annie back. Annie, it's very simple. You two are judges on the Miss USA beauty pageant. Would you cast your votes for the same girl or for different girls?
That's not simple. That's a hard question. See, I have great depth and integrity, and Bert, on the other hand, is a very surface person. This is hard. This is really hard. I'm going to say yes.
You'd say yes, what?
Yes, we would vote for the same person.
For the same girl. All right, banana section. He is a winner.
A lucky guess.
Good, you're right.
A lucky guess.
And?
Yes.
I'm curious, what is your idea of feminine beauty? Is it a curvy girl or a slender girl or...
A good cook and a neat housekeeper.
Is that what you're looking for, Bert?
Yes.
That's what I'm looking for.
You go to a beauty pageant all you want. Yes. All right. Jean, would you please tell me what you believe Helen is going to say?
Well, it's... You see, I suppose you're all expecting me to say that I'd vote for the girl with the big nads and Helen would vote for someone who's...
No, in the last 3 days, I've learned not to try to expect what you might say, Dean.
I don't know. I think Helen and I would probably vote the same way.
Same way?
Who asked you? It's your money I'm losing.
Why would you shout at him when he's doing so well for you so far? Is that what you say, Gene?
I think we do the same thing, sure.
Very good.
Yeah.
All right. May we have Helen back with us, please? Quiet now, red section. Helen, do you believe that if you and Gene were judges on the Miss USA beauty pageant, that you'd vote for the same girl or for different girls?
I think we'd vote for different girls.
You would? Well, then... I think it would be interesting to know, Helen, what type would Gene vote for?
Gene would vote for... And I would vote for someone who had a lot of class and a lot of personality.
Yes. Gene will have to watch this show on the air to know the type of girl he really likes now. Gene, she says you'd like...
Yes, of course. Well, I thought, I'd just go one step further and outfox her on that, and because I knew she expected me to say that, I thought I'd be different there. Sorry about that.
Yes. All right, Bobby.
You never change.
You know the question. Tell me, would you vote for the same girl or different girls, do you believe?
Well, we watch a lot of pageants when you host them and a lot of other pageants, and we don't always agree on the same girl all the time. So I would think that... I'm just taking a stab at this. We usually don't agree. She's liable to say we do, but I would say we'd vote for different girls.
Different girls. Very good. All right, blue section, quiet, because here comes Elaine. Elaine, would you and Bobby vote for the same girl or different girls in this Miss USA beauty pageant you are judging?
Could I have a hint? Just a little one. Nothing, huh?
Nothing.
Would we vote for the same girl or the different girl?
Uh-huh.
We would probably vote for different girls.
For different girls, the Blues love it.
You got it?
So again, we're dividing the $150. So we have $150 for Annie and Bert and Elaine and Bobby, and it's turnabout time. Gentlemen, will you go backstage? Girls, you come out here, and we'll be back with more Tattletales after we watch this.
Where's my watch?
Awesome. All right, as you can plainly see, we have the Goyles out here now, and the guys are backstage. And I have a question for you gentlemen, which is this.
All right.
As you may know, I host Truth or Consequences. Can as I... one of our consequences, we sent a fella out in the street to approach people and offer to sell them genuine $10 bills for $5. Now, if you didn't know about this little gag and you were approached by a stranger, would you buy one of his $10 bills for $5? Think it over. Goodbye, gentlemen. Helen, you and Gene have been married many years. Tell me, you know him well. Would he buy a $10 bill for $5?
No, I don't think he'd buy a $10 bill.
You say he would not buy a $10 bill for $5. All right. Let's have Gene back, please. Quiet red section. Here's Gene. Gene, would you buy a $10 bill for $5?
Certainly not.
You would not. They love you. You have answered one correctly.
That's one in a row.
Why in the world not?
One in a row. Why in the world? Well, there's no compromise with honesty. In life, there's a lot of gray area. But either you steal or you don't steal. You are honest or you are not honest.
I appreciate a direct answer. Thank you very much. Now, over here to Elaine. Elaine, would Bobby buy a $10 bill for $5?
Gee, yes. Well, how do you know?
He sold him a $10 bill.
I don't think he would. I don't know what he's going to say, but I don't think he would.
You think he would not?
I'm telling you the hidden secrets. When he comes out here and says, I have no idea.
Let's have him come out here and say it. We'll find out. Bobby? Bobby, would you buy a $10 bill for $5? That's the question.
I probably would not do it.
Would not. And we have a happy blue section over here. Now, correct answers in a row. And how is Bert going to answer?
Well, Bert's very trusting, but I've been working on him for a long time. And I don't think he would.
He would not.
No, there was a time when he would have, but now I don't think he would.
Let's bring Bert back and let him answer for himself, please. Bert?
Yes?
Would you buy that $10 bill for $5?
Well, once I bought some shirts out of the back of a guy's car. He says, hey, someone want some shirts? And I bought the shirts, I put them on, I had a shirt and a little front light, a little dicky. That was all it was. And I remember doing that, but no way I wouldn't do that.
You would not. So we have three correct answers. And now we have $200, $200 and $50. And we have this for you.
Solution from MicroTouch.
Here we go with our $300 question, and with scores of $200, $200, and $50, anything can still happen. Anyone can
Bobby,
win. Gentlemen, here's your question. You and your wife have won a showcase full of all kinds of marvelous children's toys. Which of the two of you would be more eager to sit down on the floor and play with them? You or your wife? Goodbye, gentlemen. And Helen, I'm going to start with you, and I can tell from your laugh you have your answer all ready for me. Who would sit down and play with the toys?
Oh, gosh, we both would. I think Gene would probably more.
You think
than
he
me.
Would?
Yeah.
The red section seems to agree. Let's have Gene back with us, please. Gene, would you or Helen sit down and begin playing with the toys first?
I hate this question.
Speak, baby.
Me.
You would. And you have just won because Helen predicted that you would answer that way. All right. Now over to you, Elaine. You've heard the question. Would you or Bobby sit down and begin playing with these toys first?
Well, I guess Bobby would. I don't like toys. I never did like toys. I wonder what that means. I got you to laugh.
You predict then that Bobby will play with the toys first.
Tell me what that means. That I didn't like toys when I was a kid. It doesn't matter, I know.
It really doesn't. Okay. All right, Bobby. Bobby, who will begin playing with the toys first, you or Elaine?
My wife always says, she said me.
You're right.
I don't even know what to say. I'm such a baby, she says.
She wants to discuss it in depth, which we will do immediately after the show with our writings by Freud.
She said, call your agent. No, I got to play with this Tinker toy. The hell with my agent. I'm not calling my agent.
And I want your prediction about Bert's answer.
This is so simple. This is in the bag. Every Christmas, our kids wind up in tears. Daddy won't let me have my whirly bird. Bert.
Bert.
Definitely Bert.
Let's have Bert with us. Bert?
Yes?
Would you answer, please? Will you or Annie begin to play with these toys first?
Well, I tell you, I could give you an answer, but I don't want the audience to jump in too quickly. I love to play around. It'd be me, I think.
You're right.
Yes.
You're right. All three of you have answered correctly.
Really?
The money now is $300, $300 and $150. Annie and Bert, Elaine and Bobby are the winners. And we will be talking with them after this. All right, we have a tie here. Elaine and Bobby and Annie and Bert have each won $300 for the blues and for the banana section. Of course, we add $1,000 to that from Tattletales and 65 cents of my own money to divide among the two sections. Thank you for being a marvelous audience. Thank you for being a beautiful panel. Bobby Vann will be the host of Tattletales tomorrow. You won't want to miss that. Bob Barker saying goodbye, everybody.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Give and Take next over most of these CBS stations.
Liz.
Fireworks?
Nope. Repeat it for you, Barbara, in its entirety.